Jamie Lackey in the 44 out to the lead, followed by the 5 of Steve Clark, 4 of David Price, the 09 of Brown, and then Robbie Morgan rounding out the top 5. Rice in the 0, Price in the 1, and Ackard in the double 0. One lap officially scored, and Jamie Lackey, race leader, 6 laps the distance for B Hobby Heat Races. David Price trying to take the second position away from Clark, and he's got it. Racing with this B Hobby Heat Race. 2 laps have been scored. Lackey in the 44 out in front. Points leader David Price going for the lead down the back straightaway as they go into turn 3. Lackey holding on for the lead ahead of David Price in the 4. And then James Price in the 1. The 09 of Freddie Brown, 0 of Andrew Rice, and the double 0 of Jeff Ackard. Lackey continues to lead. This will determine the inside row for the feature later on tonight for the B Hobby division. 3 laps officially scored, and now 4 laps have been scored. Lackey holding on to the lead over a hard-charging David Price. Lackey in turn 3. Price to the bottom of the track, coming out of 4. David Price in the 4 as they take the white flag. Price to the lead. Jamie Lackey falls to 2nd as they go down the back straightaway. David Price in turn 3. Price out of turn 4 to the checkered flag. David Price followed by Jamie Lackey in the 44. James Price in the 1. The 09 of Freddie Brown. 0 of Andrew Rice. Sportsman division, please report to the staging area. Sportsman, please report to the staging area. Had some problems here in hot laps, unable to make it out for the heat race. That'll move Darren Bustler up to the outside pole. McMahon and Bustler, the front row, as they go into turn 1. Down the back straightaway, McMahon to the lead in the 13. Bustler in 2nd, Pat Lackey right there in 3rd. Justin Best 4th, Jonathan Sims running out the top 5. And then Rodney Murphy. Murphy loops it around in turn 4. Caution flag out. Green flag racing as McMahon and Bustler lead the field. We go down the back straightaway. DJ McMahon, feature winner from earlier this season, looking to take this heat race win. McMahon the leader with 1 lap officially scored. A good race for 2nd, Darren Bustler. Darren Bustler going for the lead down the back straightaway, and he's got it. A little bit of contact between the B4 and the 13, and the B4 comes out of it as race leader. Darren Bustler out in front, and Pat Lackey in the 4 has moved into 2nd. DJ McMahon falls to 3rd. McMahon, though, moving into the 2nd position as he gets around the 4 of Lackey. McMahon will try to reel in the B4 of Bustler now. Bustler in the lead, followed by DJ McMahon, Pat Lackey, Willie Bustler in the 31B in 4th. Jonathan Sims rounds out the top 5, and then Justin Best and Rodney Murphy, 6th and 7th. We have reached the half, we are past the halfway point. 4 laps now scored. Bustler in the lead. Darren Bustler getting set to enter turn 3. Bustler out of turn 4. White flag in the air as we enter the final lap of this heat race. Darren Bustler in the lead. Good racing throughout the field behind Bustler. Darren Bussler enters turn three, and here he comes out of turn four to the checkered flag, followed by DJ McMahon, Willie Bussler, Pat Lackey, Jonathan Sims, Justin Best, and Rodney Murphy. That will be the outside row for the feature later on this evening. Sportsman qualifying coming up next. It'll be one lap on the clock for the sportsman drivers. Late models, please report to the staging area.
Junior in the 28 of New Haven's JT Ayers, row 2. The 11 of Campbellsville's Jeff Watson. The 99 of Corbin's Blake Brown, row 3. The 9S, also out of Mooresville, North Carolina, that's Slater McCray. And the 69 of Albany's Tim Patrick. In the final row, the 21 of Paint Licks' Corey Denny. And the 21 of Irvine's Clay Reese. Sweet Beans and Things modified heat number 1. Mooresville, North Carolina's Billy Workman Jr. and New Haven, Kentucky's JT Ayers set to bring them to green. Eyes on them, and here we go. Ayers showing the way in the 28 machine. Billy Workman Jr. is second, Blake Brown third, Jeff Watson fourth, Slater McCray and Tim Patrick going at it side by side for fifth and sixth. Then it's Clay Reese and Corey Denny. As JT Ayers shows the way out in front in the 28. Ayers, the current division track points leader. He's got a pair of feature wins already here at Ponderosa this season, and looking high, wide, and handsome in Sweet Beans and Things modified heat number 1 here for you. Billy Workman Jr. in that Diamond race car. Tomcat sponsored machine second. Blake Brown in a Lightning sets third. The Tomahawk race car of Jeff Watson fourth. And I believe the Lightning of Tim Patrick is fifth. But they're all chasing the Bandit race car. Dale Mears powered machine of JT Ayers as he'll see the halfway signal. Five down, five to go here in Sweet Beans and Things modified heat number 1. And the 2 lap to go signal goes down on this one. The 2 to go, Ayers is leading them down the back straightaway. He's going to be coming to the white flag. You're off of turn number 4. 1 lap to go in Sweet Beans and Things modified heat number 1. Down the back straightaway for the final time. And off of turn number 4, New Haven, Kentucky's JT Ayers, the winner of Sweet Beans and Things modified heat 1. Billy Workman Jr. in the 64 will come home in second, third. Will be the 99 of Blake Brown, fourth, the 11 of Jeff Watson. And a fifth will go to the 69 of Tim Patrick. Your top 3 finishers out of Sweet Beans and Things modified heat 1, third, the 99 of Blake Brown, second, the 64 of Billy Workman Jr. And the winner of Sweet Beans and Things modified heat 1 in the non-Arizona Bandit race car with the Elmer's engine, sponsored by Boone's Butcher Shop, Western States Crane, Snap-on Tools, After Hours Body Shop, MVP Garden Service, Guys Building Supply, out of New Haven, Kentucky. Big round of applause for JT Ayers. I need my 50-50 mission. Sweet Beans and Things modified heat 2. Grids like this, your pole sitter will be the 6 of Danville's Victor Lady is outside the 15 of Glasgow's Peyton Harlow, row 2. The 1 of Manchester's Eddie Stewart, the 27 of Somerset's Gerald Haynes Jr., row 3. The 231 of Edinburgh, Indiana's Brandon Reed. And the 26 of Richmond's Joseph Husband. And the R3 of Mount Vernon's Jared Ring, shotgun on the field. Victor lead, jumping to the race lead. And the Kerry Tobridge on that number six machine. Peyton Harlow second, Eddie Stewart third, Gerald Haynes Jr. fourth, Brandon Reed fifth, and Haynes will take the third spot away from Stewart. As Reed trying to work under Stewart now for the position number four down into turn three. Joseph Husband rides in position number six, and Jared Rings brings up the rear of the field in seventh. Superstock Heat, Superstock Heat to staging, please. Lawson Tractor Sales and Service, KDRA, Superstock Heat, we need you in staging, please. And a halfway signal goes out on this one, and the Lincoln Leadfoot Victor lead driving away from the field in the Kerry Tobridge Jones Diamond race car with a Pro Power race engine making the power out there beneath the hood. Peyton Harlow second, Gerald Haynes Jr. third. Brandon Reed almost got out of shape, gathers it back up though. He'll hang on to that fifth spot behind fourth place running Eddie Stewart in the yellow number one. Two lap to go being shown to the field. Two to go here in this one. And it is all Victor Lee out in front. He'll work off to number four to the white flag right here. One lap to go. Four race leader Victor Lee. Peyton Harlow riding in the bridesmaid spot. He is second. Gerald Haynes Jr. holding down third. As leader Victor Lee comes off turn number four. Danville, Kentucky's Victor Lee, the winner of Sweet Beans and Things Modified Heat number two. The 15-5 machine of Peyton Harlow will come home second. Gerald Haynes Jr. will be third. Eddie Stewart will come home in fourth with the 231 of Brandon Reed fifth. Your top three finishers, third to 27 of Gerald Haynes Jr., second.
Drivers being asked to use patience out there. They want to make sure that track is dialed in as best it can be as they come around on those first laps before it gets kind of broken in by the pack racing. And we have green, green, green racing at the gap. Tearing into the fourth turn on that first lap of this 25-lap modified street race. Landon Williams. Our speed's currently getting up around 86, 87 miles an hour is where they're topping out. Gary Blanken is in second place. Looks like we have a car's gotten clipped, left and rear goes to spin. Drivers currently being warned to keep it right at that 4,000 RPM mark. And here they go into the green flag racing for this 25-lap modified street race. Chris Rickett currently in the first place in the 36 car as he approaches the fourth turn. Looking to go down the straightaway, hold on to his position for one more. He's going to do it. Speeds maxing out up in the 90s on that last pass. Chris Rickett with a 90.4. Looks like we got one car pulling itself off of the raceway. And a yellow flag is going to slow it down. Come back around. We're green, green, green. Racing at the gap. Oh, beautiful drifting into the turn, but it was the number two car. Sorry, the 58 car of Gary Blanket gets a little bit squirrely going into that second turn. Cost him a little bit of time. So Chris Rickett still holding on to first in the 36 car. Second, Kurt Owens in the 140. Third is the 52 car of Dale Reed. Fourth, the 58 car of Gary Blanken. And in fifth place, the 21 of Ronnie Roberts. Chris Rickett still tearing up the track at 91.694 miles per hour. His lap time is a 15.704. And, oh, I spoke too soon. He loses. Oh, I'm sorry. He does not lose the lead. He's still firmly in the lead. Into lap number 8 of 25. 36 car Chris Rickett still dominating the first 8 laps of this race. Kurt Owens in the 140 car in second place. Third place, Gary Blanken in the 58 car. The 52 car of Dale Reed is at fourth, and the 21, Ronnie Roberts, in fifth. These cars hit that drift just right into that turn. A lot of them choosing that mid to low line. The 21 car getting really low and in control coming off that second turn. Their fastest time on Eleven laps down out of 25. We're past the halfway point now. Chris Rickett still in control in the 36 car at first place. Kurt Owens hot on his heels in the 140. Oh, and we have a spin out going into turn 4. Looks like he's still. Flag situation. Our standings are top 5. 36 is still Chris Rickett. He's held on to the lead since the beginning. 140 of Kurt Owens is second. The 58 car of Gary Blanken is third. 52 of Dale Reed fourth. And the 21 of Ronnie Roberts is fifth. And we are going back green flag racing. of a shootout going on in the middle of the pack. David Bullington and Jeff Ferguson in the David Bullington in the 20 and Ferguson in the 24 car, trading leads briefly on the last lap. Currently on lap 13 of 25, Chris Ricketts still holding on to that lead. Cars are going for that high line now, getting up into that grip, that dirt track. Hot laps of qualifying have cleared out a nice little groove right in the middle of the track. That's going to work against the traction of these cars at this point, so they're going to go up there into that grid. Try to spread it out a little bit. Chris Ricketts running a 92.54 lap on that last lap. Still holding on to the lead. Second place, Kurt Owens, 140. Gary Blanket in the 58 is third. Dale Reed in the 52 fourth, and Charles Bates now in the 27 at fifth. Cars are getting fairly spaced out. They started off with a pretty tight pack, and now they've kind of worked their way around into their own individual grooves. The two car of Robbie Wood running a really low line. Seems to be fighting his car just a little bit as he comes around off that fourth turn. We're on lap 19 of 25. Chris Ricketts still holding the lead. That two car still having a little bit of trouble staying low. Now he's got the bite where he wants it. Oh, we got a little spin out coming off. It's at turn four. I think that was the 25 car. Landon Williams spinning out on that fourth turn. It's going to bring out the caution. Can't thank you enough for coming out to the gap tonight, having a great time at the dirt track. I know I am. I'm Big Daddy Voodoo. I'm a roller derby announcer by training. I'm a motorsport announcer by luck of the draw. Here we are. We're green, 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 racing again at the gap. Now we're in that shootout position now. We got four laps left to go. We're on lap 21. These racers are going to turn up. Racing at the gap one more time. Never gets old. Going into lap 22. Your current standings. First place is 36, Chris Ricketts. Second place, 140 of Kurt Owens. Third place, 58 of Gary Blanken. The 52 car of Dale Reed is fourth. And Charles Bates in the 27, fifth. Chris Ricketts has dominated this race since the very first lap, has not let go of that lead. And Chris Ricketts again with the fastest time, 92.996 miles per hour on that last lap. We have white flag, one more lap to go. Chris Ricketts actually accelerating at 92.996 on that lap. And we are bringing it in to the checkered flag. And there it is, your race winner, Chris Ricketts. Second place, Kurt Owens. Third place, Gary Blanken. Fourth place, Dale Reed. Fifth place, number 27 of Charles Bates. Number six is the 38 of Brett Banks. Number seven, the three car of Caleb Trent. Number eighth place, number 20 of David Bullington. Ninth place is number two of Robbie Wood. The 20th is the 25 of Landon Williams.
Drivers the 1 to green sign this time, so we will be feature racing the next time they're around. Lackey is going to start in the third position. Jamie Lackey in the 44 will start up there in the third position. With the B Hobby Division. In the four, the race leader, followed by Darren Bussler in the B4. B44 of Jamie Lackey in third, Willie Bussler in the 31 in fourth, and in the 13 of McMahon, rounding out the top five, Jonathan Sims just outside the top five in that 30 machine, James Price in seventh, Justin Best in eighth. Pat Lackey ninth, Rodney Murphy rounding up the top 10, ahead of Robbie Morgan, Steve Clark, Andrew Rice, Freddie Brown, and Jeff Ackard. Price continues to lead the way in the four machine. Jonathan Sims will exit the track as the four of David Price continues to lead the way. Six laps have been scored. David Price out in front and the yellow flag in the air. 30 of Sims unable to make it off the track. The drivers, the 1 to green sign. We'll be back to green flag racing next time around. David Price, points leader, out in front. And the B4 of Darren Bussler in second. Jamie Lackey running in the third position. Willie Bussler in fourth. And DJ McMahon rounding out the top five. Best in the 16 and 6. James Price, the 1, running in 7th. Rodney Murphy, the 411, in the 8th position. Pat Lackey, 9th. Steve Clark rounding out the top 10. And we're back to green flag racing as David Price comes out of turn 4. Robbie Morgan, Freddie Brown, and Andrew Rice round out the field. Price in the 4, the race leader. 20 laps the distance. And lap 7 going up on the board. Price Price continuing the lead in the four ahead of Darren Bustler in the B4 as eight laps have been officially scored. Price continues to lead, but Darren Bustler in a very close second as they go into turn three. The four and the B4 racing for the lead. David Price holding on to the lead ahead of Darren Bustler. Jamie Lackey running in a very strong third tonight ahead of Willie Bustler in fourth. And Justin Best has moved into the top five. Jay McMahon, Price continues to lead the way. Sportsman division, we need you in staging. Sportsman, please report to the staging area for your feature. David Price continues to show the way ahead of Darren Bustler in second. Jamie Lackey in the third position, Willie Bustler in fourth, and then Justin Best rounding out the top five. Price will put the zero of Rice a lap down. Bustler coming with him. Caution flag out. An accident over in turn two, bringing out the caution. And giving the drivers the one to green sign. Sportsman division, please report to the staging area. Sportsman division, we need you in staging. Only eight laps remain in the B Hobby feature. Lap shootout to determine the winner in the B Hobby division. David Price leading the field down the back straightaway, going into turn three. And here comes David Price out of turn four to green flag racing. Darren Bustler in the B4 looking for the lead. Price holding him off down the back straightaway. David Price continues to lead by the slimmest of margins over Darren Bustler. Jamie Lackey in the 44, certainly not going away. Willie Bustler in the 31, Justin Best continues to round out the top five. Team lap score, David Price out in front. As lap 15 going up on the board now, Price continues to lead the way. David Price continues to lead, but good racing throughout the field in the B Hobby division. Willie Bustler in the 31B looking to take the third position. A little bit of contact made between Bustler and Lackey, and Willie Bustler comes out of it in third. Jamie Lackey in fourth. Now Willie Bustler will gain on the B4 of Darren Bustler. The five of Steve Clark entering the top five. Rice leading the way. Andrew Rice will exit the racetrack in the zero. David Price leading the way, but a good battle for second. Darren Bustler in second. Willie Bustler in third. Jamie Lackey fourth. Steve Clark rounding out the top five. White flag in the air as we enter the final lap of the B Hobby feature. David Price is well out in front, but who's going to be scored in second? David Price in turn three. Price out of turn four to the checkered flag. David Price followed by Darren Bustler, Jamie Lackey, Willie Bustler, Steve Clark, Justin Best, Rodney Murphy, Pat Lackey, James Price in the one, Freddie Brown in the 09, then the 13 of McMahon. A big win tonight. Tennessee's own David Price taking the win in the B Hobby feature tonight. And over in tier parking, he's getting set to make his way down the back straightaway. David Price in the four. And and in the grandstand area. He's getting set to come down the front straightaway. A big round of applause for the four Sweetwater, Tennessee's David Price, taking the win in the B Hobby division tonight. 17 cars signed in. When it's all said and done, our points leader, David Price, will visit the Jackie Jones Ford Lincoln Victory Lane. It's now time for the Sportsman Division.
Race fans, we need you back away from the catch fence, please. That's for your safety and protection. Let's back away from the catch fence. Ayers in the 28, Lee in the 6. They will bring them to green. 20 laps, eyes on them here off turn number 4. Green's out, and here we go. Ayers slides up in front of Lee for the lead. Down into turn number 3. Showing away out in front. Lee is second. Billy Workman Jr. third. Peyton Harlow fourth. And we got a spin down in turn number 4. Caution flag is out. Victor Lee shows the outside of the first Delaware double file restart row. JT Ayers out in front by himself. Second place, Victor Lee chose the outside. The first double file restart row. Billy Workman third. Peyton Harlow fourth. Blake Brown fifth. Eyes on him. Here we go. Three wide for sixth into turn number 3 there. Brandon Reed, Eddie Stewart, and Gerald Haynes Jr. momentarily, and JR going to come out of there with it. Ayers sets on the point. Victor Lee in second. Billy Workman Jr. holds down third. Young Blake Brown is fourth. Peyton Harlow fifth. A 17 and a 16-year-old right there going at it for fourth and fifth. Gerald Haynes Jr. sixth. Brandon Reed looks to be seventh. Slater McCray eighth. Jeff Watts is outside now, looking to move McCray back tonight. And Eddie Stewart into one, the final car in the top 10. Five laps scored, five down, 15 to go. Ayers with the lead, Lee second, Workman third, and it's a little bit of distance back to fourth place running Blake Brown. Peyton Harlow fifth. Jeff Watson trying to work beneath Gerald Haynes Jr. That's a battle for the sixth spot off four down the front straightaway. Lee going to try to look beneath Ayers as they go through turns 1 and 2. He'll fall back in line. Workman holding down that third spot still. Brown fourth, Harlow fifth, Watson around Gerald Haynes Jr. for the sixth spot now. Looking beneath Ayers for the lead. They are side by side, and both of them spin up in turn number 2. Oh, my. Oh, my goodness. Ayers and Lee battling for the lead and a synchronized spin up in turn number 2. the one to go signal. We got 8 laps officially scored, 8 in the books. Mooresville, North Carolina's Billy Workman Jr. with the field in tow at the cone here off turn 4. Eyes on him, and here we go. Watson looking to the inside of Harlow for the third spot. Yes, Billy Workman Jr. shows the way out in front. Blake Brown second. Peyton Harlow and Jeff Watson battle for third and fourth. Gerald Haynes Jr. is fifth. Brandon Reed and Eddie Stewart go at it for sixth and seventh. Slater McCray is eighth. Tim Patrick ninth. And Corey Denny, the 21 car, is 10th. KDRA Superstocks, we need you to staging, please. Lawson Tractor Sales and Service, KDRA Superstocks, we need you to staging, please. Billy Workman Jr. with it in hand at this point with 12 scored. Blake Brown second. Peyton Harlow holds the third spot. Jeff Watson nipping at his heels. He is fourth. Gerald Haynes Jr. holding down fifth. Eddie Stewart is sixth. Brandon Reed seventh. Tim Patrick and Slater McCray go at it for 8th and 9th, while JT Ayers has made his way back into the top 10. He is 10th. Five lap to go, signals down. Billy Workman Jr. working the lead, has about 3/4 of a straightaway back to second place running Blake Brown. Workman a little out of shape up in 3 and 4 right there. Gathers it back up. Workman the leader still. Brown second. Harlow third. Watson fourth. Haynes fifth. Stewart sixth. Reed seventh. Ayers eighth. Patrick ninth. McCray tenth. Oh, and Clay Reese spins in front of the leaders up at turn number 4, and that will draw the caution flag. Caution is out. Seventeen down, 3 to go. Workman the leader, Brown second, Harlow third, Watson fourth, Haynes Jr. fifth, Stewart sixth, Reed seventh, Ayers back up to eighth, Patrick ninth, McCray tenth, then it's Reams and Denny. 17 official, 3 remain. Eyes on them at the cone here off turn 4, and here we go. Watson looking beneath Harlow for the third spot. He looks like he's got that done off turn number 2. As they'll come to the 2 to go signal right here. 2 laps to settle this one. Ayers around Reed. That's going to put him back up to about the 6th spot, 7th spot. As Billy Workman Jr. will work off turn number 4 to the white flag. 1 lap to settle it. Billy Workman Jr. down the back straightaway for the final time and into turn 3. off of turn four. Mooresville, North Carolina's Billy Workman Jr. taking a win in tonight's Food Beans and Things Modified feature. Blake Brown second, Jeff Watson third, Peyton Harlow fourth, and Eddie Stewart completes the top five. Big round of applause. Billy Workman Jr. picking up the win in tonight's Sweet Beans and Things Modified, a main event. We'll let him slip around here. Young man, congratulations. First and second, JT Ayers, Victor Lee, they tangled in front of you. You was right there on them in third. You three had kind of pretty much driven away from the field and going to settle it amongst themselves. And those two, with their spin over in turn one and two, it handed you the lead. And your race car looked like it just kept getting better and better for you there in the later stages of the race.
Yeah, you know, we're from North Carolina. We race up there, and we're down here trying some stuff out, and our car is amazing. It's more me that's learning, trying to keep up with the car here. These Diamond Hornet race cars are just amazing, and this dirt over here is just really awesome. I love racing on this stuff.
No, you do a majority of your racing, like you said, down in the North Carolina region. You've done some stuff with the Renegades of Dirt Tour. Got some wins down in North Carolina. Kind of nice to venture, I guess, north of the Mason-Dixon line, if you will, and put this Diamond by Hornaday in victory lane.
Yeah, you know, it's really awesome. We had some people call us out, so we had to come up here and see what we had. And our car seemed to be all right. It's just learning the different lines on different racetracks. We ran Farmer City and ran twice and finished second both times up there. So our car is awesome. And just got to thank Ron and Lindy Hornaday, Candace, everyone that helps out. And this is just a dream come true.
Once again, big round of applause for Mooresville, North Carolina. Billy Workman Jr., winner of tonight. Sweet Beans and Things Modified, A-Main.